For 43 years, the historic Oceanside Ice Arena has stood off McClintock Drive in Tempe. And for 2 years, it has played host to the newest Division I hockey program in the land. ASU will open its third season tonight against the Ooks of NAIT. This is the pregame show on Pac-12+. Good evening, everybody, and welcome inside Oceanside Ice Arena in Tempe. I'm Joe Constantine, joined by my partner and hockey guru, Kyle Kirchvall. And Kyle, the hockey season is finally back, and what an offseason the Sun Devils did have. But first, let's touch base with the Ooks of NAIT coming in here tonight. What team is the Sun Devils going to face out on the ice?
Well, ASU is going up against a really solid Ooks squad that not only finished the regular season last year with the best record in the ACAC, but it's also a team that finished second in the conference championship. They're a super balanced roster. It really should be a good test for ASU right out of the gates.
Yeah, balanced indeed this NAIT team is. They're a team also in their 50-plus year history that has won perfect seasons, completely perfect. Two times they're coming into this barn tonight. What? Go more into depth and tell me what this NAIT team has strengths and maybe even their weaknesses.
Well, it sounds cliche, Joe, but really it all starts with head coach Tim Fraegele entering his second year now this season. He took over last summer coming into some pretty high expectations. Team was coming off of a 36-0 perfect season. I mean, how much higher can the expectations be? I think he met the expectations as far as I'm concerned for this last year. Taking a group of 16 new guys. Obviously, you have some veterans in there, but plenty of new faces to have to acclimate to the program. He really did that. Got him off to a great start and obviously a great finish as well. Looking at the numbers with this squad, the balance is immediately evident. Anytime you average two more goals scored than you allow, you're going to win some hockey games. The special teams numbers are equally impressive, almost 86% on the PK. That matches up really well with ASU, who struggled with the man advantage last season. The man to watch out for tonight, Tanner Dunkel. The senior forward is a goal-scoring machine. 24 goals and 28 games speak for itself. And Joe, ASU defenders should really have their hands full with him tonight.
And Kyle, as you mentioned, that Tanner Dunkel kid, what a joy to watch out there. 24 goals in 28 games. Now moving over to Arizona State, though. Their first season 2 years ago, they only won 5 games. Last year in their second season, they win 10. What are the chances they can go ahead and double that win total to 20? As you also noticed, they did win on the road against Quinnipiac last year and beat Air Force for their first win against a ranked opponent in team history.
Yeah, Joe, I mean, they're absolutely moving in the right direction. You mentioned Quinnipiac, the Air Force game. You also have to look at the Western Michigan and Ohio State games last season, games that officially go down as ties for the Sun Devils, but ASU gets a goal in overtime, and they win a shootout against both of those teams. I mean, that's a lot of success against some really good opponents, but when you preview this ASU team this year, when you look at the roster as a whole and really an entire organization, you have to consider the fact that as an independent school, they're going to travel a lot. They have another really tough schedule this year, but really, I wouldn't be shocked, and I think a lot of people wouldn't be shocked, if the Sun Devils came out and surprised some people this year.
Yeah, Greg Powers mentioned again, it's not about getting the most wins as they possibly can. It's, again, building the formation of this team and from the ground up as they are going into their third season. So, Kyle, they are missing two of their three top point leaders from last year, Robbie Bilargeon, Wade Murphy. Who's going to step up and get the production up that Greg Powers is expecting?
Well, one thing that Coach Powers has is a whole ton of depth. There's a lot of guys that can step in and fill these roles on the Sun Devil team, but one of the first guys that comes to mind for me is Tyler Bush, one of six guys to play in all 36 games for the Sun Devils last season. You remember he got off to that super hot start, a 4-game goal streak to get his season going, and really he kind of slowed down a little bit after that, but I think he has the skills as far as shooting and passing to really become a playmaker and really fill that role that the Sun Devils are going to need to fill this year.
And they did get some more depth in that freshman class, including the son of former great NHLer and Mario Lemieux. Talk to me about what Greg Powers has coming into this program.
Well, it was quite a summer. You mentioned it earlier for the Arizona State Sun Devils. According to Neutral Zone, the 9th best recruiting class in the country for a school that also, as you mentioned, just became an NCAA program not all that long ago. Quite a great start. But yeah, Lemieux obviously is a big part of that recruiting class. He is a redshirt though this year, so there's a chance that we don't see him on the ice at all this year, except for maybe tonight as it is an exhibition game. But fortunately for us and fortunately for everyone watching, there are plenty of names to keep an eye on this season. Three of the names that really stand out to me, you have to mention Johnny Walker, Vito Janssens, and Dominic Garcia. Walker, of course, a Phoenix native, brings a lot of leadership capabilities to this team after wearing the C for 3 straight seasons in the USHL. Just a really solid player. Janssens is a guy with a whole lot of upside. Not only does he stand at 6'4", 210, but he has some international pedigree and can really find the back of the net from the point. And I think Garcia, man, this guy can be a legitimate difference maker from day one. The Vegas native brings a great attitude, fantastic work ethic, and in the words of Greg Powers, is, quote, the ultimate leader and culture builder. So, Joe, there's no doubt in my mind that he'll be wearing a letter on his chest at some point in the not-so-distant future.
Well, it should come as no surprise that head coach Greg Powers is sticking to what worked last year. Dylan Holman is going to remain team captain for this season, as well as Anthony Crossan and Louis Rowe remaining as assistant captains. We got the chance to sit down with Greg Powers and ask him why no change in leadership, and he simply said nothing was broken.
How they evolved as a core leadership group throughout last year was really special to see. Seeing the guys take to them, the staff. You know, everybody saw our progress throughout the year on the ice, and a lot of it's attributed to their leadership. So if it's not broke, don't fix it.
Hey, gotta love what Power said there, Kyle. These guys, exciting to see what they're gonna do this year in their leadership roles. Let's move to some more serious offseason news. Patrick Kudla, defenseman out of Canada, the first ever draftee to commit to play hockey at Arizona State. He's not gonna join the team anymore, couldn't get through the NCAA clearinghouse.
Yeah, Joe, he was one of the most highly touted names to ever be associated with Sun Devil hockey, and the Sun Devils will absolutely miss having his name on the roster, but kind of a weird situation altogether. Here's what Greg Powers had to say about the whole thing.
He is not going to get through NCAA clearinghouse, unfortunately. I think he's just going to turn pro, and unfortunately he will not be with us. We wish him all the best, but it was out of our control, and we wish him the best. It was just a clearinghouse issue. Sometimes when you recruit so many international student athletes like we do and we like to do, curriculums don't match up, and for whatever reason he just didn't have what was necessary to get through NCAA clearinghouse, and we wish him all the best. It's unfortunate. We'd love to have him, and he's a great kid, and we'll see what happens.
And Patrick Kudla, definitely a championship caliber athlete. And speaking of championship caliber athletes, Denver gets the win last year in the Frozen Four. Do they have a chance to repeat?
You know, Joe, I think so. I think this team has a whole lot of potential, and they're just starting to realize it. Plus, they have senior goaltender Tanner Gillette still in between the pipes. We saw him a little bit when we traveled to the Mile High City last year. Only faced 15 shots. He did allow a goal, but I think the 15 shots just goes to show the kind of defense he has in front of him. And as long as they have that offense mixed with Tanner Gillette and that defense, I think they're a serious contender to once again regain the Frozen Four.
Yeah, for sure. Regain the Frozen Four is obviously the greatest thing they can do.
Yep.
Getting that repeat. But let's go ahead and see what games are happening this week in college hockey. Number 16 Union's taking on number 2 Boston University tonight. Another matchup to look at tonight. Charlton at Holy Cross. Arizona State will play Holy Cross in the next few months. Moving into tomorrow, Denver at Lethbridge, as well as Michigan Tech at Wisconsin. Those are my games to look forward to, Kyle, this week in college hockey.
More than a few great games to get the season going, Joe, and I'm just excited to watch them all.
Including the one here tonight. As we wrap up our pregame show, Gabe Mercer is going to go ahead and join us after the first period of play. Tyler Paley and Cole Feinblum on the call in the booth. We'll see you after the first period. Enjoy the game.
Drops on Season 3 tonight in Tempe for Arizona State as hockey returns to the desert. Oceanside Ice Arena plays host to the Sun Devils and the NAIT Ooks. Opening night in this NCAA hockey matchup here on Pac-12+.